Our little mission, where you are always welcome to seek refuge from the jungle of sin. brothers and sisters, in resisting the devil, and we shall put him to flight forever. Remember, friends, it is the Save a Soul Mission, located at 409 West 49th Street, open all day and all night, with a special prayer meeting this Thursday at 9.
Poor Miss Sarah, I wonder why a refined doll like her ever got mixed up in a mission dodge.
She is a good-looking brood. 100% eyes.
It is too bad that she wastes all her time being good. How could she make any money that way?
I don't know. Maybe she owns a piece of the mission.
Yes.
Nathan is the operator of a floating crap game that at the moment is temporarily homeless because police office of Brannigan is waging a campaign on crap games in the neighborhood. Miss Adelaide, a singer at the Hot Box, is tired of her 14-year engagement to Nathan and wants him to go legit and marry her.
Hello, Nathan, dear!
Adelaide, pitch in there. You still rehearsing?
Yeah, that slave driver, Charlie, he's been wiping us all day. Finally, I said, look, Charlie, I'm starving. I gotta get out of here. I gotta get something to eat. And he says, you don't want nothing to eat. You just want to sneak out of here and meet that cheap bum, Nathan Detroit.
And so what did you say to him?
I told him, I said, I'll meet whoever I want.
Hey, well, don't upset yourself about it. How's your cold?
Oh, much better, thank you. Nathan. Happy anniversary!
A present for me. A belt.
Read the card.
Sugar is sweet, and so is jelly. So put this belt around your belly. That's so cute, Adelaide. You know, honey, about your present. I was going to get you a diamond wristwatch with a gold band, two big rubies on the side.
Oh, Nathan, you shouldn't have!
It's all right. I didn't. I'm sorry.
No, I kind of like it when you forget to give me presents. It makes me feel like we're married.
Don't worry, sweetheart. You know, one of these days I'm going to be in money, and you'll have more mink than a mink.
Nathan, all I can do without anything. Just as long as you don't start running that crap game again.
The crap game? What an absurd thought.
Ooh!
If Nathan can raise $1,000, he can find a place for his game. He hits upon an idea. Skye Masterson is passing through town on his way to Havana, and Nathan knows that Skye will bet on almost anything. Nathan tricks Skye into a bet, whereby Nathan says that he can name a doll who will not go to Havana with Skye. Skye is sure of himself, not only in gambling, but particularly with women, and takes the bet. Nathan names Miss Sarah.
Hey, Masterson, glad to see you, Skye.
Nathan, you old promoter, you.
How are you, Skye? Gee, you look great.
I feel great, too. I just spent 2 weeks out west in Nevada. Helpful climate, beautiful scenery, and I beat him for 50 G's at blackjack.
50 G's? Hey, you're gonna be in town long?
No, I'm going to Havana.
Havana?
Yeah, there's a lot of action down there. Hey, you want to come along?
No. I got a lot of things to do. But in the meantime, I figure, you and me, we go down to Mindy's, you know, we have a little cheesecake. You know, they got the greatest cheesecake there. They sell a lot of it, too.
Nah, I'm not hungry yet, but how's Adelaide these days?
Oh, fine. You know, still dancing at the Hot Box.
Ah, I suppose one of these days, though, you'll be getting married.
Well, you know, we all got to go sometime.
Yeah, but Nathan, guys like us, we gotta remember that pleasant as a doll's company may be, she's still gotta take second place to Aces back to back.
Yeah. But tell me, you hungry yet? You know, I figure we go down to Mindy's, you know, we have a little cheesecake, maybe some strudel, something, you know?
No, I think I'm gonna go get the late result.
You will admit, though, that Mindy's got the greatest cheesecake in the world.
Yeah, I am quite partial to Mindy's cheesecake.
Well, who ain't? But, you know, there's some people that like Mindy's strudel. And, you know, offhand, Sky, I was wondering, which do you think Mindy sells more of, the cheesecake or the strudel?
I never gave it much thought, but if everybody's like I am, probably sells more cheesecake than strudel.
For how much?
Huh?
For how much?
Nathan, I never knew you to be a betting man. You always take your percentage off the top.
Well, I figured for old time's sake, I'd give you a little action. I will bet you $1,000 that yesterday, Mindy sold more strudel, I think it was, than cheesecake.
Nathan, let me tell you a little story. When I was a young man about to go into the world, my father said to me a very valuable thing. He says to me, the old guy says, son, although I am not able to bankroll you to a very large start in life, I'm going to stake you to some very valuable advice. One of these days in your travels, a man is going to come up to you with a deck of cards on which the seal is not yet broken. And he's going to bet you that he can make the jack of spades jump out of the deck of cards and squirt cider right in your ear. But son, do not bet with this man. For as sure as you stand there, you'll have an ear full of cider. Now, Nathan, I don't claim you've been clocking Mindy's cheesecake.
Hey, you don't think this
guy... However, if you want to make the same bet, I'll bet you that same $1,000 that, you do not know the color of the necktie you now have on. Well, come on.
No bet. Ooh, what a crazy cup.
Hey, Nathan, we took Adelaide to the drugstore.
Don't bother me!
Hiya, Sky. How you doing?
Yeah, how's it with you fellas?
Not bad.
Nicely.
Yeah, that's good.
We took Adelaide to the drugstore, and she said for you to pick her up right after the show at the Hot Box. And don't be late.
Yes, dear. I mean, yeah.
Yeah. Yes, dear. That is husband talk if I ever heard it. In Adelaide, you have found the kind of doll that is most difficult to unload.
I don't want to unload. I love Adelaide. Anyway, a guy without a doll, well, if a guy does not have a doll, who would holler at him? A doll is a necessity.
I'm not putting a rap on dolls, but they're really easy to come by.
Hey, not dolls like Adelaide.
Nathan, figuring weight for age, all dolls are alike.
Oh, yes? Yeah? Then how come you ain't got one? How come you're going all the way to Havana, alone, without one?
Look, I like to travel light. But if I wish to take a doll to Havana, there's a large assortment available.
Hey, not real high-class dolls.
Any doll. Any doll, you name her.
Any doll. I name her?
Sure.
Will you bet on that?
Sure.
Will you bet $1,000 that if I choose any doll, you go to Havana with her tomorrow?
You got a bet.
I choose her.
Her? Oh, cider.
Guy discovers that Miss Sarah's mission is going to be closed because it attracts no sinners. He cleverly offers her his marker for 12 genuine sinners to attend that special prayer meeting if she will have dinner with him. General Cartwright is planning to attend that meeting and will rescind the order to close the mission if there is a sizable turnout. To save the mission, Miss Sarah agrees to have dinner with Sky, not realizing that dinner will be in Havana.
Hey, Doc, I'll make you a proposition. When's this prayer meeting of yours? Thursday? I'll guarantee to have 12 genuine sinners at the meeting, and I'll further guarantee that they'll sit still and listen to you.
And what's my end of the bargain?
Have dinner with me.
Why do you want to have dinner with me?
Because I'm hungry. Here.
What's this?
What is this? This is Sky Masterson's marker for one dozen genuine sinners. If you don't think it's good, ask anybody in town. I owe you one dozen genuine sinners. I'll pick you up at noon tomorrow for dinner.
At noon?
Yeah, well, it'll take us some time to get there.
To get where?
To my favorite restaurant, that's where.
And where is that?
Oh, El Cafe Cubana in Havana!
Havana?
Yeah, where'd you want to eat, Howard Johnson?
Havana?
Listen, I now realize, Sister Sarah, that no matter how beautiful a sergeant may be, she's still a sergeant.
And I now realize, Mr. Gambler, that when you were describing the blackness of your heart, you did not do yourself justice.
Why don't you change your pitch, Sarge? Come to the mission, one and all. Except guys, because I hate guys.
I don't hate anybody.
Well, I'm relieved to know it's just me personally, not all guys in general. I wonder, though, what kind of a guy it would be that would attract the sergeant.
He will not be a
gambler. I'm not interested in what he will not be. I'm interested in what he will be.
Don't worry. I'll know.
For I've imagined every bit of him, from his strong moral fiber, to the wisdom in his head, to the homeo-roma of his mind.
You have wished yourself a Scarsdale Galahad, the breakfast-eating Brooks Brothers type.
Yes!
And I shall meet him when the time is right. Oh,
Nathan